हेलो, माय नेम इज़ माधुरी थोरा फ्रॉम एएसएसएमएस कॉलेज फ्रॉम आईटी डिपार्टमेंट। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू अ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ डीएफए, हाउ टू सॉल्व अ डीएफए प्रॉब्लम। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी सी द प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट। ड्रॉ अ डीएफए फॉर द लैंग्वेज एक्सेप्टिंग स्ट्रिंग एंडिंग विथ ए बी बी और इनपुट अल्फाबेट ए and B. Now we are going to create a DFA which will accept only those language in which the string is ending with ABB. It means we have to generate a string which can be end with ABB as a substring. First of all, we identify the language. In this, first smallest string is ABB, so the length of a string is 3, so we required a 4 state. In this language, all strings are accepted only the ending with a substring ABB, so the language can be ABB, AABB, BABB and so on. Only the string it can be accepted which is end with the ABB. And the next step is we will construct a DFA for the following state. Draw, first of all, for the simplicity we have to draw a first DFA of a smallest string, that is ABB. So this DFA Q0 is the initial state and the Q3 is the final state in which ABB string will be accepted by Q3. So afterwards we have to draw a DFA for the other acceptable string also. See the state Q0 over an alphabet AB in which A input symbol already passed towards the Q1. A symbols is already passed to Q1. So the only B symbol is remains. So first of all to check the possibilities of symbol B. We can't give a B symbol to the Q1 or Q2 or Q3 because the string will only the end with ABB. So we give a symbol B to Q0. Then we check the next state, that is Q1. In Q1, B symbol is already passed towards the Q2, so only remains A symbols. So we have to check the possibilities of A symbols. We can't give A symbols to the Q2 because the string will be AAB and the string will be the end with AAB. It cannot be accepted by Q3. So we have to give A input to Q1 itself. Next state will be the Q2. Q2 having a two states, two possible inputs, that is the A and B, but B input already passed towards the Q3, then only the A, and the maximum possibilities of A symbols is towards the Q1. So we pass towards the Q1. And the next last one is the final state. We can't give of A and B as a self loops towards the Q3 because the string is ended with only the ABB as a substring. So we give A as the maximum possibilities towards the Q1 state and the B we can give towards the Q0. Next we see the tuple of DFA. Okay, tuple of DFA is explained as M equal to Q summation del Q0 and F. Q is the set of input states, that is the Q0, Q1, Q2 and Q3. Summation is the input alphabets. We use A and B as the input alphabets in this DFA, in this language. Del means the transition function and the Q0 is the initial state, or we can say that the starting state. F means the final state, and in this DFA Q3 is a final state which is denoted by double circle. Okay, this is a transition functions which is represented by del. It has a it having a mapping between states and input alphabets. Okay, we see one by one. Okay, Q0 is the initial state, so it is represented by arrow, and the Q3 is the final state, so it is represented as a star. So first of all we check the state Q0. Q0 A input is passed towards the Q1, so we write here as a Q1. Next, Q0 B input is passed towards itself, so we write as a Q0. Next state is Q1. The A symbol is passed towards itself, so we write here Q1. Next, Q1 B symbol is passed towards the Q2, so we write here Q2. Next state is Q2. Q2 A symbol is passed towards Q1 and the B symbol is passed toward the final state, that is the Q3. So we write here A Q1 and the B passed towards Q3. Q3 is the final state and it is denoted by a star, that is asterisk. Q3 A input is passed towards Q1, that is, so we write here as a Q1, and the Q3 B symbol is passed towards the Q0. Okay, I think you all are understand how to design a DFA and how to draw a tuple of DFA. Okay, thank you.